we'll be doing everything we can to protect the United States.
What is the State of the Union? What do you think it is?
The lips of America.
Actually, that was very profound. I'm not 100% sure what it is either. So, if you were president, what would you do?
Give out everybody money, poop in the toilet, like stand in the toilet seat forever.
Okay. I made us a game. The game is called, actually it doesn't have a name. You have to guess if it's a tweet from Trump.
He's a very bad name.
A text from my dad, or a quote from Moira Rose from Schitt's Creek.
God, my hair's getting nervous.
No, it's fine. We're all pitching in these days, dear, like communists or non-union actors.
Donald Trump.
Moira. All right, consider this camel's back broken.
Moira.
It is Moira, you're right. Can you help me build a website? Seriously and confidentially, please.
Moira.
No, it's Papa. Papa loves the Kardashians.
I don't know all about your dad, okay?
I went from very successful businessman to top TV star to president of the United States on my first try.
You asked me, John.
I know, I messed up. I gave it away. Can you imagine an alternate universe in which I've actually died? Wow, I wonder what you'd be saying.
Moira.
It is Moira. He reminds me of a spoiled brat without a properly functioning brain.
Okay. That is definitely Donald Trump.
Well, I suppose I'll head back to the scene of the crime, with which I had nothing to do.
Moira.
This is Moira. Did anyone see Bruiser's interview with Diane Sawyer Friday night? If so, thoughts?
Papa.
Yeah, it's Papa.
Because look, it looks like a text.
Okay, well, now you're cheating.
Bruce Bader Ginsburg.
It's just flagrant irresponsibility to allow an unscheduled conception to occur.
Donald Trump?
Nope, Moira. He is an enigma wrapped in a conundrum bow-tied with a mystery.
Moira.
Papa. Sorry, losers and haters, but my IQ is one of the highest, and you all know it. Please don't feel so stupid or insecure. It's not your fault.
Donald Trump! And also, I'm Mikey V from YouTube.
So, how did you know the ones were Donald Trump?
I heard brat and idiot.
Wait, do your best Obama impression.
I'm Obama. Hi.
Do you think I'm gonna ever be president?
Nope.
Why?
You're fearless. You're fearless.
Oh my god, thank you.
I do not know how my mom's gonna think about it. Just say, what does idol mean?
It's like someone that you look up to and you wanna be like.
Ruth Bader Ginsburg.
What?
Your life is really cute. I'm just saying. Dab.
Oh my god, you get me. Oh my god, you so get me.
Jeff Goldblum?
We don't know if he was born daddy.
Obama? You think Obama wasn't born daddy?
No, Obama has always been daddy. Okay, anyways.
Okay. Just like, listen, guys, like, we know things are depressing, things are horrible.
You're prepared to die as well.
But remember, in the moments of the movies, this is right before the climax.
Cannot be brave without being a little scared.
And that's true, and that's why we're here to tell you
a few inspirational tales. The tales of triumph,
defeat, redemption.
Hit it. When Alexander Hamilton lost his mother, his cousin, his son, the $10 founding father, when he lost all that,
was he like, meh, British fucking was an integral part of the American Revolution,
created the national bank,
two-party system, which arguably is,
I think he meant for it to go this far,
or like the two-party system to like, it was a lot smaller, it was good then. So this is what we really gotta talk about. He was accused of stealing money.
He's like, if we're gonna have sex scandals in politics, I'm gonna be the first fucking one.
But I did not steal money. Yes, I fucking cheated on my wife with this girl named Mariah.
But that's what I call a barter.
He outed himself.
I love that.
He was
about
like,
him.
People, just sometimes when you make a mistake, fucking own it. Like, you just might end up on the fucking $10 bill. When Daniel Hillard threw an irresponsible, impromptu birthday party,
to jump around, glaring.
And a donkey in the house.
Yeah, choreographed dance on the table. Okay. Which
iconic.
Respect.
Yeah, iconic. His wife came home and considered this camel's back broken. He got his own apartment. He was depressed. He still loved her.
Did he just consider that camel's back broken?
Right, I'm only seeing my kids one night a week.
Throw in the towel when his wife started seeing another man. We got Mrs. Euphigenia Doubtfire.
Mrs. fucking Doubtfire. He taught them commitment.
True love.
Responsibility. Shrek, who's an introvert, who has seceded from society.
I'll get Princess Fiona. You're gonna give me my swamp. Then he fucking convinces Fiona to become an ogre.
To not be ashamed. Like, it's not her fault she's cursed. Who gives a fuck if she's an ogre?
So, moral of the story, be an ogre.
He peels those layers and he lets Donkey in.
I haven't watched Shrek 1 in a while. When Baby went on a casual getaway with her very strict conservative family.
Jewish family. In the 60s, that's important.
So, you do the math.
Did she let poor Penny just have to have this unwanted pregnancy with that prick waiter?
No, she carried a watermelon.
They wanted him to do the fucking pachango. No, she used her privilege.
She used her privilege and she used it well.
You need to give some credit to her dad. Emily Gamon just sat back and was like, this shit's crazy, but she gets it from me.
Moral of the story.
Fucking have the time of your life.
Descent. Babe, when Andy King was presented with a choice. Forget Gil, this is life or death. Andy King knew that Evian was just
a blowjob away.
Did he say absolutely fucking not? At home, he took a shower. He gargled some mouthwash.
Please tell me, Andy, you've gotten some dates from this documentary.
Or like some job offers.
Use what you have to get what you want to stand by your people. Okay, that would do that for you.
I mean, I
don't think it would like take you a lot for you to do.
Brendan Dassey. Is he out?
Is he giving up? No, he's waiting it out. Because you are the star of your own story.
That was sad. I didn't know he was still in there. When Emperor Cusco.
He had everything. He was a prince. He had a palace. He was going to build a water park.
What does Yzma do? She turns him into a llama. Pull the lever, Kronk! He finds perhaps the most gentle llama herder in all of the land. Do you know who Pacha is?
John Goodman. I'm sorry, but if John Goodman shows up in your story, this is going to be an adventure of the heart.
John, take the wheel.
Deep allegory for the 1% if they only could look past their little bubble.
Unfortunately, we can't turn everyone into llamas.
You know, Stella got her groove back. Cusco
lost his groove
and then found another.
When Richard Nixon.
This is a lesson in like, sometimes look around and you should give up.
This is a lesson on swallowing your pride.
Like, sometimes listen to the people around you. Richard Nixon also created Roger Stone. And he has a tattoo of Nixon on his middle back. It's like, just make it a tramp stamp. Like, go for it, Roger Stone. Like,
I did not know. How do you know that?
You haven't seen that? I'm sorry.
Is that him?
He's weirdly buff. He's but a good old tricky dick.
When Edmond Dantes is deceived by his best friend, thrown in jail for some...
Not just jail, but like medieval...
Like
island,
like the level of deceit, betrayal,
and loss.
Just downright horrible living conditions.
What does he do?
What does he do? He comes in on a motherfucking air balloon as the Count of Monte Cristo.
And you know what? I don't always advocate for revenge.
But when we do advocate, you don't react. The true proponent of revenge is a dish best served cold.
This is a lesson in playing the long game.
He comes in on an air balloon. He's like, oh, I am the Count.
This is different than the book.
Obviously. What do you mean?
I'm one more that I would add, but...
No.
This one, like, kind of breaks all the rules, but...
No. Whatever it is.
When Cuba getting genius...
Babe! Oh my god! And you say that I have a problem breaking rule number 3?
Oh,
don't get Cuba into this. And you always say, you have no problem with rule number 1 or 2, but for some reason, you got a problem with rule number 3. Babe.
Babe. Babe.
Love this journey for us.
Love that journey for me.